social media.
One,
how do I
go.
Stop all these waves?
I can't do that.
It delays.
Alright, okay. Right, so Sonic Ditto, Palutena's Temple, because we couldn't have Sonic music.
Huh?
What is allowed?
Alright, so yeah, Aperture a bit ahead, but it's not like, no, it's pretty even, to be honest. Both feeling each other out right now.
Oh, yeah, it's fine, it's fine.
Okay, so right now, Sonic would be looking to maintain stage control, because once Sonic has been forced to use his spring, he can't use any other specials.
Yes.
So keeping him into the air for as long as possible is really, really important in this matchup.
Yeah.
More often than not, you will see Sonic just dive down and burn down there, because it's cancelled, but it's a lot bigger than other times.
Yes.
In a similar way.
Yeah. But I mean, playing a Sonic Ditto at a high level, like, they're going to have a really good... they're both going to have a really good feel for the down air or to cancel window, so they'll know exactly when to punch you.
Yeah. Okay, it's Edge Guard in here, a bit interesting. Not. See, the thing is, it's really difficult to edge guard Sonic, because the spring is, like, has a lot of vulnerability on it.
Yeah.
And when Sonic releases spin dash, it has a vulnerability on that as well.
Yes.
So if Sonic chooses, like, spin chop on the ledge and just dash all the way past, it's very difficult for most characters to punch it. So Sonic is not so hard, but getting him off the ledge will be difficult.
Yeah.
Like that's literally what I'm saying. The spin chop there, just going straight across.
Yeah, exactly,
and because
yeah.
Because Aperture committed to a roll, he wasn't able to actually get to it.
Like, oh wow.
Yeah, Smash calling out that spot dodge, I think it was.
Yeah, that was a spot dodge, yeah.
Yeah. Man.
This is such a pure baiting game right now.
Yeah.
Trying to bait each other when they both know the character so well, must be like, the level of mind games going on right now must be so huge.
Yeah. Back row should go easy. Yep. 170, like way past the range where back row would go to the ledge. I don't agree that air dodging to the ground, Ace should know better than that. If a Sonic is charging spin dash and you're in that kind of scenario, you should never try to air dodge that close to the ground, because you're always going to get caught. There's nothing you can do in that situation except fast fall and get down as close as you can.
Yeah. Okay. Oh, no, that was...
typical fashion, Ixus SD. Nice.
I feel like they're both going for, like, safe damage options. They're not going for any fancy, like, strings, because they both know the characters, obviously. So they're just trying to get that guaranteed damage.
Exactly, they know the windows.
Yeah.
Now, there is a very brief window where Sonic can't actually get any true combos off his up throw.
Okay.
So he primarily goes for that.
Yeah.
That's the kind of thing I'm talking about. He'll go straight in for it, because most people will try to air dodge knowing it's not true, and then he'll get the back end.
Right.
Ixus playing well, though. Yes, he not seem to have faced him, still, you know, maintaining good control of the neutral.
Yeah, that's good. That's really important.
Yeah. So let's just see if Ixus can take control of the stage here. Nice. So right, so Aperture air dodged really far away from Ixus there, so he was able to shield before Ixus released.
Right.
If Ixus released a little bit earlier, it would have been fine, but maybe he was fearing the lightning aerial. Roll the way there to avoid that. Nice, really good air dodge read, but Aperture catching that Ixus was a little bit slow, training it with the up air. Ixus probably thought he could tap the stage there, and that's why
yeah.
He died down.
Right, yes.
Ixus perhaps playing a little bit too much there near the ledge.
Right, so he gets caught with the spring, so he can't take advantage of Ixus' landing.
Aperture got lagged there. More often than not, you can actually go into some really nasty strings off that. Even at low percentage, you can two combo that to up smash.
Right, okay. Okay.
Doesn't matter who's going to pull the trigger first. It'll be Ixus. We'll cover it. Yep. Aperture nearly being able to punish the landing. A lot of Sonics do that. When they land back down onto the ground and someone's dashing towards them, they always spot dodge. Always. That'll be a two stock coming in from Aperture. Unfortunately, SD by Ixis, but yes. More than good enough for the player to make a comeback.
Yeah, I feel like Aperture was still like was still gonna win that game, even though Ixis SD, like, he seemed quite he seemed to have the reads where Ixis didn't.
Yeah.
Especially that F smash to take the first stock. That was
yeah. I feel like Aperture is more willing to take more gambles.
Yes.
I feel like Ixis is a very calculated, calm player. Yeah, with him being my training partner, I pretty much gathered this through every time I play him. All of his decisions are always calculated. He doesn't like to take risks. He doesn't like to commit unnecessarily.
Right. Yeah, I can definitely see that in their play. Aperture went for quite a few like F smashes there.
Yeah.
In neutral.
See, in some ways, I do actually prefer, you know, throwing not so much mix up, but like if you are so certain the opponent's going to jump or spot dodge. You know, a grab isn't always, you know, good enough. There's going to be that next level where the opponent's going to be like, okay, you're jumping, F smash. Like,
yeah.
You're jumping back air. Like, Ixis even said himself that the Sonic player, current best Sonic in his opinion, Ken,
yes.
He seems to think that Ken's whole game plan is basically off reading jumps. And that is something that Ixis is trying to implement into his play.
Okay.
But I feel like he hasn't quite gotten the grasp of it yet because he isn't, like... He isn't fundamentally able to read jumps that well.
Okay.
Like, Ken is like a world-class player, so
yeah.
He's just manipulating.
Yeah, I haven't actually watched much Ken, but I've definitely heard that his combo game and, like, baiting defensive options like jumps and air dodges is just incredible. Like, he gets so much off one punish.
Yeah.
And Ixis, obviously, is really good at getting a lot of one punish, but,
yeah.
Like, Ken is just a world above a lot of other Sonics in that regard.
Yeah. As you can see, both Sonics just really, really optimal with in terms of their movement. Look at all of this platform movement, spin dash cancels, you know, all of it really, really crisp, actually.
Yeah. Yeah, I was thinking that when he was playing against Scarfelt. Like, Scarfelt, he plays Fox, but he just couldn't catch Ixis' movement because it was so clean all over the all over the playing field. Like,
it's always just a matter of who's going to pull the bullet first.
Yeah.
Who is literally just going to go.
It's just bang, it's just pure baiting.
Yeah. Up B, yeah. So when Ixis was landing there, Aperture went to the left side of the stage. That was a really bad decision because although Ixis still had tools available to him, you can at least force him to expend it and then try and get a read off that.
Mm.
But instead, he ran to the other side of the stage, let Ixis land for free, and then get anything off it. And that was a mistake on Aperture's part.
Yeah, okay.
And because of that now, Ixis has taken a small lead, almost showing it into the up air, which definitely would have killed the 11%.
Yeah.
Ooh, really good air dodge reading tempo.
This is really even compared to the last one. We'll see if Aperture gets another read on a defensive option. Use the down throw to send him off stage. Oh, he was waiting for the air dodge, but he didn't air dodge there, he just jumped out of the way.
Yeah, Aperture not being good at all. Wait. Almost 3 minutes into this game. First time he's not been taken. Still not been
Yeah, safe. Not quite high enough percent. Although he does have almost max rage.
An up throw will definitely kill Aperture, but I don't think an up throw from Aperture will kill Ixis.
Okay.
Or with a couple of pummels it might kill Aperture actually. So it's not that strong.
I think they're both being... I don't know if it's just me or if they're both being a lot more patient right now.
Yeah.
Just trying to get a read on a movement option.
Nice.
Oh, that was a nice
really
read.
Really good air dodge read. I don't blame Aperture for air dodging it. It was a really bad situation.
Yeah.
So that'll be the first stock going over to Ixis, and we have currently crossed the 3 minutes 30 time mark in terms of time done, and we've taken one stock. Nice.
That's the Sonic Ditto for you, I guess. Like,
yeah.
Any Ditto where it's all about just like baiting each other, just
really
pure
boring.
Just pure bait and punish. It just takes so long. Especially if they're both in each other's heads, neither of them wants to commit because they are scared that they will, the opponent will know what they're going to do.
Yep. And that spin dash really good at punishing neutral get up or get up attack because of the partial invulnerability. You can also get combos which send the opponent back off stage as well.
Wow.
I like how Aperture's trying to control landing now. Like, look, there we go. That's exactly what I wanted to see from Aperture. Just going in, repeatedly trying to pressure.
Yeah, catching the landings definitely seems key in this matchup for sure.
Yeah. This is why Ixus really likes this stage as well, because he's able to just like spin dash past you, spring up, land on one of the platforms. He still has to take some pressure, but it's not like a guaranteed punish or anything like that. Whereas like on FD, he pretty much has to go to the ledge or just heavily mix up his landing. Oh, a lot of landing lag on that back, I believe. Yeah. 30 frames.
Oh, wow. Yeah. Damn.
Yeah, very, very laggy. The up throw interested me there. I thought he'd go for the down throw and try to go for positioning, but okay. It was guaranteed damage, I suppose. Damage over positioning, especially against
him. Yeah, I didn't try anything fancy, just get an up air for that up throw. I think up air's his fastest aerial, isn't it?
Yes, it comes out on frame 5.
It's scary because like tech flubs like that are a great opportunity for the opposing Sonic to take advantage. And bad situation, but he got out of it really well.
Yeah. Both players playing very well right now. Very happy about Aperture's performance here. It's not just that he's good at the mirror, Aperture's showing fundamental prowess, good landing punches, good edge guards, and good mix-ups, and all of it's just great. Ixus though showing that he is still one.
Yeah, that was a really well-spaced back air. He got it with the very tip of the toe right there.
Yeah.
I don't think Aperture was expecting that.
And the thing is, it was completely safe, no pressure at all. Aperture was all the way up there. Ixus easily could have just fast-fall back down to the ground. Mm-hmm. Opting for the upper again, slipping out of the upper.
Yep. Is that a specific DI or like DIing left out of it or?
Can do with rage and starting hitbox and the carrot 2 you're fighting.
Right.
Like characters like 0-2 fall out a lot more. Did he just run into that?
Yeah, I mean that's what it looked like.
Yeah.
I think he was covering like the spacing he was at, he was covering everything up to the ledge.
Yeah.
So Ixus just had to drop shield and do something and he would have been caught.
Although the F smash hit, I still don't think it was a good idea. It wouldn't have gotten killed or anything like that, but there was no conditioning for it at all. It was like literally Ixus ran forward and he threw out the most random forward smash. So I don't think it was a great idea, but it worked. So.
Yeah, it worked. Yeah. So, yeah. Fair play. Sometimes you just got to throw out a random smash.
Yeah.
Be unpredictable.
If you can just condition.
Oh, that was a lovely tech chase.
Yeah. Hey,
ooh.
Actually doing a really good job there trying to read that offstage.
Yeah.
Oh, 20 seconds
left from the clock. Yeah, Ixus needs to... oh no, Ixus is ahead. Aperture needs to get some damage on.
There is actually still a chance.
Yeah. Well, it's running out quickly.
Yeah.
Alright, fair enough. So it's 1-1.
Yeah, 1-1. It's best of three.
Yep.
So the next stage pick will decide it. Ixus going there, I'm not surprised about. Aperture knows it's a good stage for Sonic, and that's probably why he didn't ban it. I imagine the bans were like Lila and maybe Duck Hunt or Smash Bros.
Yeah, Duck Hunt, yeah.
Yeah. So we're back on FD again. Ixus is clearly not fazed by game one, probably being a bit more confident after game two.
Yep.
Hopefully this is a bit faster. I don't think I want to sit through 8 minutes of patient Sonic.
I mean, there's no platforms to sort of hide behind. It's all very bare on this stage, so catching landings is very one-dimensional compared to platform stages on this one.
going for that dash grab. Sonic's dash grab is very, very bad.
Yeah.
It slows down his momentum, so he can't actually, like, you know, just go for a dash grab attempt like most characters, and it really hurts his ability to move in the unreactable zone, which is like the dash attack or dash grab range.
Yeah.
It's a lot smaller, despite being such a fast character.
I feel like if he did have a really good dash grab, though, then he would just be insane.
It'd be ridiculous.
Yeah.
Absolutely ridiculous. I definitely think it's the design choice, because Fox has a bad dash grab as well, and he pressures in a similar zone as well.
Yeah, that's a good point. So, Ixlis is a bit ahead. It is looking similarly slow to last game, to be honest.
Absolutely not committing. Trying to catch the landing.
He's just doing short hop, auto cancel up airs.
Ooh.
That was an opportunity, and he takes it, and that will be the stock off the top with the back air.
I wasn't the best, but I'm pretty sure he still was there.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking.
If Aperture doesn't end this soon, I think we're going to see a true example of why Aperture still has that little bit of a road to go.
Right.
So he made a good job to come back there, but I really want to see it in a scenario where Ixlis is a bit more ahead, because when I've played against Aperture in the past, whenever he's behind, he kind of crumbles a little bit.
Right, okay.
And there he did a really good job to kill up there. He didn't rush anything, just punished the jump from the ledge, got the back air. It was really good. But I want to see now what happens if he falls behind again and if he can maintain it.
Yeah.
But he's doing a good job of, you know, just staying in there, landing those hits when it matters.
In this sort of match, the little things like that matter a lot. Like, getting in your own head. Especially when it's this sort of archetype of character.
Yeah, when someone's momentum based on Sonic, that's really important.
Yeah.
I think he was going for a jab lock there into a forward smash.
Okay.
Got a buff dash attack. A big difference when these two are playing, actually. Aperture will sometimes turn around the spin dash, whereas Ixlis will never turn.
Okay.
Ever. Ixlis only goes forward with his and then cancels it into something, whereas Aperture won't be afraid to come back at you again, despite how slow it is.
Okay.
So definitely a big difference between the two.
Oh, no.
And it's another SD from Ixlis, falling quite far behind Aperture now.
Yeah.
But Ixlis is a player known to make good comebacks being in this position.
Yeah. I mean, it was like quite a high percent anyway, so
it's
not like he lost a fresh stock, so I don't think he's too bothered. But at the same time, like, I just saw him there, he was sort of trying to work out what happened.
Until the stock is over, you still have a chance to come back.
Yeah,
so
exactly.
Losing any stock is still really important, even if it was a higher percent. However, having said that, he was in a terrible position. So even if he didn't SD, there's a good chance he would have been edge guarded.
Yeah.
Okay, Ixlis is doing a good job of trying to grind this back.
Aperture, he's being quite patient now. Or maybe he's sort of, he's trying to... Oh, wow, okay. He went for that down air off the top. But Ixlis just springs right out of it. Oh, wow.
Oh, catching the jump and a two-stock coming in this last game.
Okay.
Yep, so I'll be Aperture taking it again.
Yeah.
But
I believe last time it was a 2-0.
Yes.
So,
yeah,
I mean, at least Ixlis took a game this time. Performed really well in that second game. But yeah. Sonic Ditto. We're through with the Sonic Ditto.
Yeah, we are through, and we've now got
we've
some
made
Samus
it.
Coming on the stream.
Yes.
So that should hopefully
that
be
should
a bit more of a, you
know. What?
A bit more of a thriller. I think in reflection from that set, Aperture was literally just more willing to take more risks.
Yeah.
And they all paid off for him.